Oh, come on, let's go. Stop number 7 of 9 events on the Bassmaster Elite Series. Welcome to the Toyota Bassmaster Studios. I'm Tommy Sanders with Mark Zona and Z. We're going bass fishing, middle of the summer. You want a place with good weather, but more importantly, you want great bass fishing. I think we got them both covered this time.
No doubt about it, Tommy Sanders. And really, the Bassmaster Elite Series is known for going to some of the best fisheries in the entire country. And a lot of people think, you know, Florida, Alabama, Texas, California. Well, anytime the Elite Series goes to the state of New York, they crush them. And this lake right here, Cayuga Lake, you had better crush them if you want to survive.
All right, huge expectations. Let's see how they played out on day number one.
All the way from Osaka, Japan, former Elite Series champion Morizo Shimizu. 23 pounds, 6 ounces! 23 pounds, 6 ounces! Morizo mauls him on day number one. Boom shakalaka, giant bass.
Great stuff for Morizo Shimizu, looking for his first win since 2006. As great as that day was, he would be overshadowed by this guy, our leader in points coming in.
Here he is, leading toward a Bassmaster Angler of the Year, Greg Hackney. 17 pounds and 8 ounces, moves into 19th place currently.
Well, that would turn out to be 36th place when all was said and done, enough to keep for the time his leadership and points, but all that would change after it was revealed that an infraction had taken place.
New York has a law, especially on these glacier lakes, where these man-made marinas, dugout marinas, are private property. And Greg indeed had entered one of those areas just by mistake, but his day one catch was disqualified.
Well, just a terrible thing to happen because obviously no attempt to gain an advantage on the field was made.
Yeah, I really don't think we've seen a penalty like this cover in the Bassmaster Elite Series. And here's really the whole story is Hackney was fishing outside of the marina, fishing a bunch of those, well, they're just moored buoys where people hook up their boats to. And then he eased into that off limits. And, well, like everybody in the field, just they feel horrible for Greg Hackney.
That's a bad deal. I feel terrible for him. But you know, it was an honest mistake. I mean, you know, he didn't do it, you know, he didn't try to intentionally do anything wrong. That's the thing about it. He just made a big mistake. We all do it.
The thing is, by no means did he try to do anything, you know what I'm saying? I mean, to do anything wrong, and it just a bad situation.
You know, you get so excited about fishing a tournament, and you get some good bites in practice, and a lot of times you're just doing it and you miss something, and that's all that happened. He missed it.
He's a good friend, good buddy, and I'm pretty sure he'll rebound. We're going to two grass lakes next and then smallmouth fishing, so he's going to be tough to still beat.
And if Greg was listening to this, what I would tell him is he's still very much in AOI, the race for AOI, and he can't let a mistake like that, you know, knock him back.
And the good thing is for Greg, he's not out of it, you know? I mean, if I was to even win this tournament, I'd only be like 13 points ahead of him, so.
Still in fourth place, he's still right there, and he's got a legitimate shot to win with three tournaments left.
It's about all the excitement you'd ever want on day number one, that and more. So we're gonna move on to day number two as we get our field to full field. Again, fishing on day number two. And in this field today, hey, he could have taken off, but Greg Hackney is back in this thing. I mean, you know, he fell to fourth place after that day one catch was disqualified, but still not out of it. His friend said so.
Yeah, but you also have to think about what is going through his head right now, especially in a tournament. Looking at your leader, Morizo Shimizu, Kevin VanDam. This is a tournament, really, if he catches them here on day number two, it's going to be almost impossible to gain a point. But getting back into this tournament, there is so much going on Cayuga Lake right now. Here's the best way to describe it. There's fish spawning, done spawning, coming, going, and really, Morizo Shimizu has nailed that. Not fishing a very big area, fishing a grass bed on the east side of the lake, whether it's been with a bladed jig, a jerk bait. But the great part about fishing in the month of June in New York, you can catch some giant largemouth.
Morizo Shimizu wasting no time, trying to keep the momentum going from day number one, and it isn't long before he has loaded the boat once again. Not the weight he had on day number one, but very encouraging start to his day.
Got it. Big one. Thank you. Yes. Nice.
Well, not a bad day at all for Morizo Shimizu. Five fish limit, a good one too, but nothing near what he had on day number one. 16 pounds and 10 ounces will drop him down to third place after day number two.
One of the most consistent anglers on the Bassmaster Elite Series the last 2 years, Jacob Powroznik from Virginia. Very, very solid weight, 40 pounds and 3 ounces. But on day number two, this was the story.
21 pounds, 7 ounces. Carhartt Pro Jordan Lee crushes him on day number two of the Busch Beer Bassmaster Elite and rockets into the lead.
Jordan Lee in his second year with the Bassmaster Elite Series. No wins yet for him, but hey, it's just a matter of time. Ask anyone associated with the sport. Definitely the star of the future out here, taking a lead into the third day. Jacob Powroznik, Morizo Shimizu, Rojas, VanDam, and on down the list, there's some strong, strong fishermen in this field as we get ready for the third day.
The Busch Beer Bassmaster Elite at Cayuga Lake is brought to you by Skeeter Boats. Humminbird. Mercury. And by Minn Kota. You're watching the Busch Beer Bassmaster Elite at Cayuga Lake.
Bassmaster Elite Series from the Finger Lakes region, Union Springs, the village of Union Springs, New York, a beautiful place, and that's where we're starting out each and every day. This is day number three with our field now cut in half after 2 days, and these anglers getting ready to go out there on this day, which is very, very important. The competition is so tight here, about a 4-pound spread will cover the entire top 12. Everyone's got a sort of a different way of dealing with all this grass, all these opportunities they have.
No doubt about it, and very, very little wind here on day number three, and it's really the anglers that are sight fishing, fishing for spawning bass, looking at them, and then the anglers that are completely ignoring them. But to win here, everything has to go right.
I'm going to go out there and start on a smallmouth I found late in the day yesterday afternoon on bed. I don't really know how big it is. I think it's 3 or 4 pounds. It's down there kind of deep.
Today's going to be the day. You know what I'm saying? Today's, I mean, look at it out here. It looks like a mirror, and it's supposed to be like that all day. So we're going to get to look at them, and the only thing we got to do is catch them.
To win a tournament of this caliber, you know, the stars really have to line up. And all the guys will tell you the same thing. I mean, you don't really get an opportunity to win much. So, but like, it's a long way from over at the halfway point, and we'll see if I can't put a good day together today.
And really, the lay of Cayuga Lake is very interesting. This whole north end of this lake is a giant, massive grass flat. Jordan Lee's only going to run a couple miles up the northeast side. But these largemouth are not everywhere. Very, very key isolated areas. But when you find one of those areas, they can be loaded up.
This year, my goal was to come in to make a 12 cut this year. I never made one last year. You know, I'm exceeding my expectations for the year, but that's always a good thing. So, you know, it's just a lot of fun when you get on a roll. You know, this sport can be the most humbling sport out there. You can have a dream day and come in the next day with nothing. So when you're doing all right, you know, you're doing good. It's just, it's a fun time.
There's a big one. You good? We got him. There we go. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. There's a big one. Mm-hmm. That's a good one right there. 4-pounder. Put him on the big side.
Youth, enthusiasm, and a whole lot of skills, Jordan Lee. I mean, take a look at this stat. 34 tournaments with the Bassmasters, 26 of them in the money. Another member of the youth movement out here. Our leader in Rookie of the Year points, Drew Benton of Florida. How about Drew Benton? 21 events with the Bassmasters and 14 of those in the money. These two strong hands at a young age.
I think I finally got it where it needs to be. I don't think he's that big though. Bit it again. He must just be like trying to run it off. He'll get mad and eat it here in a minute. Got him that time. Playing catch with it.
Drew Benton, a very nice keeper right here. And out here on Cayuga, you're expected to catch him, as you said, Mark Zona, each and every day. And the third day, maybe even a little more important because we're trying to get it down to 12 anglers who fish for the championship on day number four. We're going to take a break. When we come back, this strong day three will continue.
Okay.
Top five guys to start this day.
Find it. Four more. Big one.
Bassmaster Elite Series for 2016. This is the Bush Beer Bassmaster Elite. Cayuga Lake, Union Springs, New York. This place is a paradise in the summer for people who love great weather and great bass fishing. It attracts people from all over, and it's attracted the Bassmaster Elite Series this time around. Let's take a look, Mark Zona, at the spot favored by probably our two strongest sight fishermen out there.
No doubt about it, and really, here's the weird thing about Cayuga Lake. These fish spawn on the north end very, very early. That water warms on the north end, kind of where VanDam and Jordan Lee are fishing today on day number three. But early in this event, Drew Benton, Jacob Powroznik, VanDam, and Jordan Lee really exploited the big smallmouth in this lake that spawn later down the lake. And not only that, a lot of these flats down the lake, they're later to warm, and largemouth will actually move up. Kind of the negative of it is there's not a ton of them down the lake that are spawning. Well, a lot of our anglers, as this tournament has gone on, well, a lot of our anglers, they're watching each other do damage. They're really kind of cannibalizing themselves.
Gotcha. What do you got? I don't look like no 19 pound. Got 2 5s.
Better have 3 6 pounder.
Huh?
Did you better have 3 6 pounder?
No, I got 2 5s. 3 1/2.
He ain't got no 19 pounds.
Messing with him.
He's acting like a little butthead.
Jacob Powroznik, Drew Benton having a little bit of fun with each other, a little bit of gamesmanship as well. Here on the final day, these guys doing some sight fishing there, and they are very, very good at it. I'm going to welcome you right now to the Shell Rotella Bassmaster Garage. Mark Zona, those guys working the grass the best way they know how. They're all in pursuit of Jordan Lee, though, right now. He's doing something a little bit different.
Definitely. Really, if you look at the north end of Cayuga Lake, it's its own environment. If you think of like a cornfield, that has a crop circle in the middle of it, that's what you're hunting on that north end. You're looking for holes in the grass. And really the other side of it is that north end has just received a ton of pressure. And guys like Jordan Lee, Brett Hite, the main thing that they've had to do in this tournament after day 1, 2, and 3, really they've had to downscale their techniques. But when you get a bite, generally when you get a bite on that north end, bunker in, lock down, and pick it to pieces.
Caught a lot of fish today. I probably caught 25 keepers. You know, I stayed on the north end of the lake today, you know, pitching a drop shot. That's what I've caught all my fish on pretty much exclusively the last 2 days. the darker holes in the grass seem to be where the fish, they're spawning in there. They're spawning all across this flat. Once I get one bite, I'll kind of settle down and, you know, try to pitch around and get some more bites. Little chunk. Caught a lot of fish. Had a really fun day, just not any of those 5-pounders like I was looking for. It's a good area for sure. I just need to, you know, maybe expand on it and try a few different baits, see what we can put together. It's gonna help. Here we go. There we go.
Jordan Lee, our leader, coming into this day, like he says, expanding on this area, really taking advantage of it. Let's take a look now at our leader from day number one, fell down to third place, and look at that spot.
Look at that grass bed to the right. Highlight that fish right there. Yes. His line's good. Now, I'm going to say that's a carp, unless it's an 11-pound
bass. You don't
know? But the other side is, Morizo Shimizu very hurt with the lack of wind here on day number three.
Big one. Big one. I need a big one. Giant bass. Yutoshi wa. Giant bass. No more big one? Nah, maybe stay here.
Biggie.
Stay on. Stay. Got it. Find it.
Oh, that's a good bass right there for Morizo Shimizu. Caught some even better on day number one, and at this point of the day, he needs a couple of those big ones from day one very, very quickly, but I'm afraid he's running out of time as we wrap it up. Day number three, trying to get it down to 12 anglers. Crowd ready to go here. Union Springs Frontenac Park. Let's weigh him in. Let's just get it started right now with Morizo Shimizu. Again, had 23 pounds plus on day number one. Keeps falling down that leaderboard a little bit, but still in the top 12, seventh place after day number three.
Another angler with a lighter day three stringer. Drew Benton started off so strong in this tournament, but steady year and a steady tournament, sitting in sixth place after day three.
A fantastic start to the year. Dean Rojas, he's always there when we go to New York, has notched out a win over at Oneida, moving up the leaderboard, fifth place after day three.
Well, you knew he was going to catch him here on day number three, one of the best sight fishermen in the world right now, Jacob Powroznik, 56 pounds and 2 ounces.
So watch out for Powroznik, and watch out for this guy, just two tournaments from his big win down at Toledo Bend. Kevin VanDam, who obviously feels very, very comfortable in these surroundings.
Just around the corner from VanDam, Brett Hite, who says, I have found the winning school of fish, second place after day three.
And let's check in with our leader after 2 days. Jordan Lee coming in today and knocked him out again.
Day two leader had 40 pounds and 8 ounces as he left the dock this morning, looking for 16-12 to take the lead back. 17 pounds, 10 ounces. Jordan Lee back in the lead at the Busch Beer, a Bassmaster Elite, 24 years old and looking $100,000 square in the eye.
Jordan Lee looking strong here, and as Dave Mercer said, possibly taking a look at his very first Bassmaster win in his young career. But look at who he's got to get past on the final day, the likes of Brett Hite, Kevin VanDam, Powroznik, Rojas, it just goes on and on. Iaconelli in the mix, too. We have our 12 who are set to go on the final day. Look at those weights. There's not too much separation. It's going to be a good fight on day number four. We'll have that getting started when we come back.
The Busch Beer Bassmaster Elite at Cayuga Lake is brought to you by GoPro. Nitro. And by Toyota.
Final day and a gorgeous morning here in a gorgeous place, a summertime paradise to be sure, the Finger Lakes region of New York State, Cayuga Lake. Union Springs, we're down to 12 anglers. On this final day, lots of savvy bass fishing fans around here. They've come out to watch what they expect is going to be a great battle on this final day.
No doubt about it. It's been a catch fest. We're going to have a little bit heavier winds later in the day here on this championship Sunday. But you really look at Jordan Lee and what he needs to get done here. To go into a final day leading the likes of Brett Hite, Kevin VanDam, Jacob Powroznik behind you, Jordan Lee, as calm as any angler we've ever covered, has his work cut out for him.
Day four. I'm pumped up, man. You know, ready to see what today brings. It's going to be a good day, you know, either way you look at it. Great opportunity. We're going to go have fun.
We just got to execute today, and you got to have four-plus pounders, so I've got a lot of good spots. It's been a blast to fish this week. Right now, we're after Jordan Lee.
On this day, 40 miles of Cayuga Lake to fish, but Mark Zona, would you serve us up our Yamaha Unlock the Lake? Because I know there's a section of it you think is most important.
Fairly simple. The north end of Cayuga Lake is really where the biggest largemouth population lives, stays, and eats. Kevin VanDam, just like Jordan Lee, fishing holes in the grass about 9 to 11 feet of water. And the other side about Kevin VanDam, he said, "Bud, when I set the hook in the morning, it's generally a good one."
Big one. That's the ones you need right there. There we go. Start the day right. Right where you're supposed to be. Right now I'm just throwing a Texas rig 5-inch Strike King Ocho, just a blue craw color. I don't think the color matters. Anything green pumpkin. This section is on the north end of the lake here. There's a huge expanse of flats. And I mean, most of it, you know, for the next, you know, 2 miles is basically about 10, you know, 8 to 10, 12 foot of water. And it's all got grass. The size of these fish, you can tell they're just feeding up so good. There's perch, there's bluegill, there's everything. So this lake right here has just got a tremendous amount of great habitat in this part for largemouth. I've got one area here that, and I've kind of watched that, really I haven't seen many people fishing around that I haven't even been to yet. So I'm kind of looking forward to that too. There we go. Nice one. Good solid one anyways. We're gonna have to have bigger to win. When I can see them, and you know, it's no secret, I'm sure Jordan Lee, Iaconelli's right up there. A lot of the guys are fishing this way right here and been making it really work. If you find one of those really good holes, you know, that you know they're in, this has been really good too. So I've just taken a same Ocho and wacky rigging it, putting on a spinning rod. Yesterday when it was slick calm, that was about the only way you could catch them. So you just cast it out there and just let it painfully sink to the bottom and twitch it a few times. Usually they got it before it ever hits. That's kind of what you're hoping for.
Kevin VanDam, a good flurry to take over that lead early on this fourth and final day. You heard what he said. I got to catch 4 pounders today. Had some that are getting close to that region. Meanwhile, Jordan Lee, our leader to start the day, a little bit slower start.
I wish I could come out of the gate and just smash 20 pounds, but it don't work like that. Not what I'm doing. I'm gonna have to work for everyone, but that's all good.
Well, one thing that we said coming into Championship Sunday, this south wind was gonna help and it was gonna hurt some anglers throughout this day. Really what it's doing is pushing a lot of that cold, deep water onto that north flat so far. Jordan Lee on the receiving end of not being helped by that win, just around the corner from him. Head over to Brett Hite, who said he truly is on the mother lode of Cayuga Lake.
That's a good one. That's a good. Oh, we come out.
See, when you lose one like that, it's gonna takes a little while for them to usually get fired up again.
I might switch this up since we.
Yeah, yesterday I pulled up here and they were really, really schooled up. You know, caught about anywhere between 30 and 40 keepers. Today I got here, little breeze, which actually should help the bite. But the fish, they just haven't grouped up here. I had a big one on and lost it in the school. And as a lot of people know, when you lose them about, you know, you get three or four cranks on them, it'll mess the school up for a little bit. So I'm just waiting for them to regroup a little bit on this spot. Got one. All the conditions are right. I just kind of messed up the spot for a little bit. And they just kind of come in waves here. You'll get three or four bites, and then you got to wait and maybe reposition the boat, kind of angle the boat a little bit different to get the right cast, find out where they've moved on the spot, and you know, just wait them out. There's a big school of big ones around here, so you just got to wait till they want to fire up and bite.
Brett Hite having a fantastic season, two top 10 finishes already. Under his belt is day four, not going quite as fast as day three, but at this point, he's got time and he's got the patience. We'll be back with more when we return.
You're watching the Busch Beer Bassmaster Elite at Cayuga Lake.
Final day of a big one here, Elite Series event on Cayuga Lake, and this is what they call the Elite Series Expo. Everybody turning out for the food, for the fireworks. A lot of music going on and fishing fans all over the place having a great time. In Union Springs, fireworks out on the water. That's what Jacob Powroznik is trying to make happen on this day, which is not as slicked off as day three was. Not as
fireworks
conducive to him.
And fun,
oh,
Tommy
and
Sanders.
All the way.
That's what's going on at this Elite Series tournament. And really, you know you're on a good lake when really you have sight fished the entire event. The wind kind of kicks up, kills that bite. And you catch him on everything you throw. He has caught him on a jerkbait, a topwater, a wacky rigged worm, a drop shot, and somehow, on this final day, Jacob Powroznik is still in it for the victory.
Please be a bass. And it is. Getting a little bit bigger, boys.
Things steady and maybe even shaping up a little bit for Jacob Powroznik. As you mentioned, Mark Zona, versatile enough to keep on catching him on this very different weather today. Back over to KVD, who started out strong.
So this is the rig that I'm using right here. I've just got a straight king, 1/8 ounce tungsten weight, a 3-aught must-head grip pin hook, wide gap. It's got that little pin on there, and that really helps keep that bait from sliding down.
Well, that right there is going to be the Skeeter Boats Taste the Bait of this tournament, and really the whole story of this tournament is the north end of Cayuga Lake. Here, VanDam throwing a Strike King 5-inch Ocho, and it's sort of a little power finesse deal going on in the north end. VanDam throwing that Texas rig worm, other guys drop shotting, but the whole key, you cannot say it enough, is the holes in the grass in 9 to 11 feet of water. And really, it's its own environment. There's bluegills, perch, gobies in all of these holes. And the beauty of it is, all of the good holes have a little bit of rock in it, and the aerials really tell the entire story. And generally, these holes have reloaded all week.
Good one. Biggin'. Good one. It's five. Right now I've got two good ones, you know, 3.5 pounds or better, and one other 2.5 pounder and two little keepers. So just been pitching my Texas rig Ocho around. You can do it. I'm just texposing it and putting it back in. There's so much of that stringy grass, and it's critical to make it straight. So bait just glides down there in those holes. And I've got a couple of key spots that I've been getting a lot of bites out of, you know. We'll see what we can do here. Maybe get another one or two off this spot.
Kevin VanDam solid on his plan for the day at a time when he says the lake is alive. It's at peak time right now. Let's check in with Dean Rojas. Dean Rojas starts his day a little over 2 pounds back of the leader, Jordan Lee, and 2 pounds is certainly doable on this day. But like Kevin VanDam said, it's the same story for Dean Rojas. You're going to have 4 pounders in the mix.
Well, you're not going to have a sight fishing tournament, really, and not have Dean Rojas in the mix. But the one thing that Rojas has had every day of this tournament is one or two giant smallmouth.
That's a good one there. Don't amp him. It's a giant. Come on. It just came from there. Oh, look at that. Oh, yeah. Look at that beauty, huh? Those are the ones that I'm used to catching this week. 4 pounders. Beautiful big smallmouth. Oh, love it. I'm gonna put him on the side over here. Beautiful. It took me long enough.
Well, that was a dandy smallmouth for Dean Rojas right there. Just what the doctor ordered. He'll need more of that. He wants to catch our leader, Kevin VanDam. Jordan Lee started with the lead on this day and still looking to put his fifth fish in the boat.
That's what I'm talking about. A little bit better. They're getting bigger. That's what we like to see. There we go. We're gonna catch some fish.
Well, Jordan Lee now with his limit of fish and about 10 pounds estimated at this point right now, which still puts him behind Kevin VanDam. Kevin VanDam, who's still just a couple of events away from his first win since 2011 on Toledo Bend.
Exactly right, and really watching VanDam fishing in a style we don't see very often. Dead stick and a plastic worm, just old school fishing. And really, this is turning into a tournament VanDam can steal with all the light weights on this final day.
I don't think I got a little one, I think. Yeah, bigger than that one. Still ain't much. Pounder. I How about that right there? Yeah. I could tell.
Oh, another little one. It's not much, so.
Yeah, how about that right there now? Yeah. Kevin VanDam having a little fun with us, the fans, and having fun himself.
Having a time.
Incrementally upgrading out there and looking very, very strong as we head into the final part of this fourth and final day at Cayuga Lake. Can he bring home his second win of 2016? Find out when we come back.
The Busch Beer Bassmaster Elite at Cayuga Lake is brought to you by Berkeley. Yamaha. Hook. And by Triton Boats.
Final day, last chance day at Cayuga Lake in the Finger Lakes here for the Bassmaster Elite Series, seventh stop of the year. There's the man who started with the lead today, Jordan Lee of Alabama. Was he going to pick up the very first win of his Bassmaster career? Well, right now, he can feel the time slipping away and possibly this tournament slipping away from him. He's got to make something happen and make it happen very quickly, very profoundly if he wants to get back in the race.
It's a decent call.
Small call right there for Jordan Lee, trying to scratch his way back into the lead here on the final day. From there, going to head about a mile and a half away over to Brett Hite, who, like Jordan Lee, having a very, very slow final day.
Green is my next call. Green, green, green. There are still bass left in this lake. Oh, it's a largemouth. It's a decent one. Wind's starting to pick up. Pretty good clip right now. Almost got to be winding something. It's hard fish slow. Came up here to the shallower grass, a little more stained. Caught quite a few in here in practice. Yeah, it's been kind of a tough day, not really going the way I want, but things can happen quick here. Oh! I know what that was. Was that a largemouth? It was? Huh. Hi. I can't wave, I'm trying to catch a bass. Finally. I watched that one eat it.
Was that the weirdest break-off that we've ever seen on the Elite Series?
What happened? I couldn't, you know, and then the fish jumps out of the water again. That was very weird. Brett Hite needs some more of those really, really quickly. Kevin VanDam just trying to hang on to what he's got, hold off everyone else, and win this thing in the final hour.
Here's one. Feels like a big one, too. Yep, it is. I have not thrown a jerk bait yet. Three pounder. I
a good sign though. Let me say that. A heavy 2 3/4 maybe. A fat one though. There he is. Solid.
Boy, an interesting final day on Cayuga Lake, a lake that really has given up giant bags all week long. That south wind definitely turned this lake around. VanDam with small upgrades all day long. Was it enough?
Okay, got rid of all the little ones in there. We've gotten rid of all of our time for fishing for today. This is gonna be the final weigh-in to decide our champion. Back here at Union Springs and the crowd ready to go. Let's take a look at Koby Kreiger, 69.8 on the week. And look at this, that has him tied now with Jacob Powroznik. These two with the lead. We can get both of these old boys in one hot seat, I don't know.
But don't you guys get too cozy over there, because this next one's pretty scary, huh? He is a 7-time Toyota Bassmaster Angler of the Year, 4-time Classic Champion, 21 wins from Kalamazoo, Michigan, KVD, Kevin VanDam. Had 56 pounds, 6 ounces, looking for 13.3 to take the lead. 15 pounds, 7 ounces. Kevin VanDam knocks off Koby Kreiger and Jacob Powroznik. Get a seat in our hot seat, your tournament leader, Kevin VanDam. Whew. Ladies and gentlemen, we have two anglers left to go. From Phoenix, Arizona, B. Hite, Brett Hite. 12 pounds, 8 ounces, moves into second place. 2 pounds, 3 ounces short of the lead. Are you ready to decide this, ladies and gentlemen? A former Carhartt College bass champion. Get loud for Jordan Lee. Looking for 13 pounds and 12 ounces. 12 pounds, 10 ounces. KVD gets it done. Kevin VanDam. The Busch Beer Bassmaster Elite belongs to Kevin VanDam. 2016, KVD doubles down with his second win of the season. Win number 22. My friend, nobody ever again better ever utter the words, will KVD win again?
Well, he's the man, no doubt about it. How about win number 22? With the Bassmasters for the one and the only Kevin VanDam. And Mark Zona, I heard Dave Mercer loud and clear. Never.
Ever.
Ever.
Never,
not for me.
Ever.
Never. Ever again will we doubt Kevin VanDam.
No, and really, it's almost like other anglers have woke a sleeping giant. And if you look at the year that Kevin VanDam had in 2015, a lot of people doubting his future. I think he's put that to rest. And the other side of that is this year is far from over. You could see another W in the tank.
Might want to keep your eye on one. Maybe. Kevin VanDam. Another thing we're keeping our eye on is Toyota Bassmaster Angler of the Year. Our point series, very important the further we get into the season. And based on what happened in this tournament, you see we've got a brand new leader, Gerald Swindle, based on 3 top tens and no missed cuts along the way. That is a very, very great record, something for him to try hard to hang on to, and he will, because he's got some great competition up in the top 12 along with him. Let's take a look at that. Gerald Swindle, Keith Combs, Jacob Powroznik, Randall Tharp, and our guy coming in, number one, Greg Hackney, based on washing out day number one here, down into fifth place, but still pretty tight race.
No doubt about it, if you really look at it, especially the bodies of water that we're going to be heading to. We're going to shallow water fisheries. Man, it is still anybody's ball game, to where really for the last few years, when we get to this point of the season, starts to become a little bit of a blowout. That is not the case right now.
All right. Speaking of shallow, we're going to the Potomac. Haven't been there in a while. What's it? Give us a big broad strokes picture of that.
The Potomac's in good shape. You know, last year was a little bit of a down year. Not the case. They're definitely going to catch them at the Potomac. And from there, we'll be heading to the Mississippi River. Here again, just a body of water. You had better be on them.
One favorite for fantasy pickers out there.
Oh, I hate to say it. You have to go with VanDam and everything right now.
All right. Toyota Fantasy Fishing, plenty of fantasy to grab onto before the season is over. We'll see you next time right here on the Bassmaster Elite Series.